तुमका ही दियो फादर
या
तुमका ही दियो फादर
या नाउ ऑन सैटरडे वी लर्नड प्रोनाउंस वन एंड प्रोनाउंस टू फाइल्स डू यू हैव एनी डाउट देयर इन प्रोनाउंस दिस इज द प्रोनाउंस वन One minute, let me tell you. Where we learned first person, second person, third person, and we did few exercises. Then we went for pronoun two. Here, do you have any doubt? Otherwise, I'll close this file and go to pronoun two. If you have the doubts, I shall clear it. All these exercises we have done. All we have done this, so probably you don't have doubts. So we will go to pronouns two. Pronouns two is this. We learned some other pronouns, kite, kon, and I said kite is used for non-human beings and things, and kon for human beings. Then we did all this. Exercises we read also I mean we means you read everything this we did so any doubts no doubts so we shall proceed now to the pronoun third one now look at this very carefully pronoun There are forms. These are the third person you know. Toti te, you know. But there are other pronouns. Ho. This person. Ti means she, yes. But she is not close to you. She is far away from you. To is not very close to you. She is far away from you. Therefore you say toti te. Ho he he. They are very near to you. Proximity is there. Therefore, we say, ho, ho kon, ho majo bhav, ki kon, ki maji aavai, something like that. He kon, he maji, bhai, maji bhai, small girl. Or he kite, he mazar. So, this is also pronoun. And there is another set of pronouns. This has got plural, like to has got plural te that we have learned in pronoun two. We have learned that. No, in fact, in pronoun one we have learned the plural of to ti te. That is te tio ti. Same way here, ho, he, he, yo, he, he. Then, jo, whoever. G, feminine, whoever, and J, whoever, and they have the their respective plurals, J, Jo, G. Okay. Now, these pronouns have their own declensions. They change their form. English doesn't have a declensions and conjugations. But Konkani has certain thing. Now, for example, let us take here first person, second person. First person is aun, you know that. Singular is aun. Plural is ami. Don't worry about right hand side. You just look at only first column, second column, and third column. Okay? Here I have written case. Now it's very difficult to explain in case because English doesn't have a case system. Latin has, Sanskrit has, Portuguese has. English, no case system. So, nominative. What do you mean by nominative? That is a direct form. The form which is given. How is the direct? You cannot remove anything from here. Nothing you can remove. Same way here, you cannot remove anything from here. If you remove the meaning changes, so they are called nominative case or direct case. Okay, now From this word is derived, maka. It means to me. It is called accusative case or dative case. Don't worry what is accusative case and dative case. You concentrate on these forms. This I'm giving more technical one. Those who know European languages and they are interested to know what case is this, it is for their sake. Only those who know English will not profit from this. Okay, something will profit, not totally. So you concentrate on this form. How? Means I. Maka means to me. And look at here. Ami becomes amka, to us. How to use these words in a sentence, we shall see later on. Have is an agent case, instrumental case. Who did this work? Have, by me. Ami only remains same, by us. Here also Ami, nominative case plural also Ami, and agent plural case is also Ami only. Then comes locative, location, one. Majer means on me. Amcher means on us. Locative two, Mager. I put a star asterisk here. This form is used by Hindu brethren. Catholics rarely use. Therefore, I put asterisk here. Mager means at my place. This is the form mainly used by the Catholics. Amger, at our place. And okay. Then third locative. Majant, in me, and amchant, in us. Next case, possessive case, mazo, the meaning I given right below here, okay, here, mine, mazo, maji, maje, and plural of mazo is maje, look at the spelling, mazo, but plural is maje, j. It is not maze, it is maje. Maji, plural majo, and maje, plural maji, all meaning mine. Pay attention to this, mazo, or maje. Plural of mazo, amcho. Amchi, amche. A plural of this one, amcho. Amche, amcho, amchi. That means ours. Once again, let us go to then. This you have to learn by heart. Otherwise, you will not understand the meaning of a sentence. Aao. Ami, maka, amka, ave, ami, majer, amcher, mager, amger, majant, amchant, mazo, amcho, maji, amchi, maje, amche, maje, amche, majo, amcho, maji, amchi. All this is about first person singular. This column is singular and this column is plural. Now we shall go to second person. This is first person. Aao, ami is the first person. Second person we have learned already. Tu, tumi. Then, tu, tuka. Tumi, tumka. To you. Tuve. Here, tumi. By you. Tujer. Tumcher. On you. Once again, this form Tuger is not usually used by the Catholics, but our Hindu brethren use it, and it's correct form. Tuger, Tumger. This is used mainly by the Catholics. Tumger. At your place, at your place. Tujant, Tumchant, in you. Then possessive case, Tuzo, Tumcho. Tuji, Tumchi. Tuje, Tumche. Tuje, Tumche. Tujo, Tumcho. Tuji, Tumchi. Yours, yours. Once again, let me go. Second person, singular, plural. Tu, Tumi. Tuka, Tumka. Tuve, Tumi. Tuje, Tumche. Tuger, Tumger. Tujant, Tumchant. Tuzo. Tumcho. Tuji, look at the spelling here. Because Z-I is not acceptable in Konkani. Therefore, Mazo becomes Maji, Tuzo becomes Tuji. Z-I in Konkani, not acceptable. Except exceptional words maybe. Otherwise, that Z becomes J. Same way, Z-E is not acceptable in Konkani. Therefore, it becomes T-U-J-E-M. Tuje. Tuzo, but Tuje. Tuje, Tumche. Look at here, Tuje. Not Z-E. Z-E is not acceptable. Z-I is not acceptable in Konkani. So, Tuje, Tumche. Tujo, Tumcho. Tuji, Tumchi. When I say not acceptable, not just spelling wise, pronunciation wise, if you put here Z, then the pronunciation becomes Tuzi, Tuzi. Nobody, Konkani speakers don't say Tuzi, we say Tuji. Konkani speakers don't say, if you put Z here, that pronunciation becomes Tuze, Tuze. We don't say Tuze, we say Tuje. And here it becomes Z if you put Tuze. We don't say Tuje. Tuze, we say Tuje. So, this you have to take note of it. So, this is the derived form of the pronouns from Aum, Ami, Tu, Tumi, first person, second person. Any doubts do you have?
Yes, Father.
Yes, please ask.
Why are there so many options for mine and ours? I didn't understand that.
See, possessive case in Konkani, mozo followed by a masculine noun. Mozo put, my son. Your question I'm answering already, but in exercise it will come. But to make you clear, mozo put, you must say. Put maji du. My daughter, you cannot say mazo du. Maji du. Maje ghar. Okay. Neuter gender. This is masculine, okay. This is feminine, this is neuter. If you have a masculine noun, singular, it has to come here. If you have a feminine noun, singular, it has to come here. If you have a neuter noun, singular, it has to come here. Okay. And maje, you have the object as plural, maje put. When you say maje put, that means you have more than one son. Mazo put means you have one son, understood. But when you say maje put, we don't know how many sons you have, but we are know you have more than one son. Okay. Maje put.
Understood.
Duo. Maji ngara. Therefore, we have this possessive case in Konkani, so many. In English, has got only one word.
Okay, understand.
Has so many. So this is the richness of the language, or the uniqueness of the language. Each language, as I said, is unique. Unique. We cannot compare languages and say this is the greater language and this is small language. There is no great and small languages. No. All languages have their own uniqueness. And same way here, plural of this one. When you say amchopput, it refers to two of you are speaking. You and your life partner can say amchopput. Amchidu. Two of you are speaking, parents are speaking, then they will say amchopput, amchidu. Amchengar means our house.
What is the meaning of amchedu?
Yes, you can say amchendu, yes.
But what is the meaning of...
Huh? Small girl, you can say amchendu.
Okay, du means girl.
Yes, du means girl, yes.
Okay, father, thank you.
Same way, this one, okay? You will see in sentences. I'm giving you this as a one paradigm. This you have to learn by heart. Meaning you must know. If I've given all the meanings I've given, you don't need me for the meanings. When we practice it, then all this becomes evident. Then you cannot ask me what is the use of maje. You're supposed to know maje means mine. Majant means in me. All that. Okay. We shall go here. I've given here, these forms are not usually used by Catholics. Which are those forms? Tuger, Mage, Maje, not Maje, Mage and Tuger, these two forms are not usually used. Some people may be using Catholic, it's not absolutely, they don't use at all, no. Therefore I said usually, not used. Now we'll do the exercise and then you will understand the meaning, all that's what we have done. We have learned this word earlier, up. Maka or amka, papayidi. Give me a papaya or give us a papaya. Means give to me. That is the meaning. Maka, accusative case. Now, this you can, you don't have a hard copy. If you have a hard copy, this is much easier to explain. Now I have to go up and down and you people in disadvantaged position because you don't have a hard copy with you. See, maka, I explained here. Maka and amka, correct? To me, to us. This we are practicing here now. Maka, amka, papayidi. Now you can remove papai and you can put ambo. Maka, amka, ambodi. You can remove that and you can say perdi, gova. Maka, amka, perdi. See? You can create a number of sentences. Maka, amka, javandi. Give us food. Maka, amka, coffee di. Give us coffee. Maka, amka, chadi. Give us tea. Maka, amka, keledi. Give us a banana. Pokelindi, give us bananas. See how many sentences you can create. Just remove this papaya and other nouns you can put, either singular or plural. Now this word, for instance, narl. It is narl, N-A-R-L, and not nal. That's a dialectal pronunciation. Narl. You can say maka amka narl di. Give us a coconut. Give me a coconut or give us a coconut. Am I clear in this? You
yes,
can replace papaya by any noun, singular or plural, and which makes sense.
Father?
Yes?
Father, that when will it become diyat? In the first sentence, when it will become diyat?
This you are now, this you are referring to whom you are saying. When you say di means you are saying to a known person or to a younger person. But to a unknown, same sentence become maka amka papai diyat. Then you are speaking to a respectable person. So let me put here then. Since you have a doubt, I will add here itself right now. Now is it clear to you?
Yes, Father.
Maka amka papai diat. In a respectable way, you're saying. Or you're giving a command to maybe to your maid servant or to your son. I mean, nobody uses, I mean, Congolese speakers don't use plural to their own son or to their daughter. In Hindi, yes. In Lucknow Hindi, I told you, they use aap even to a child. But we don't go to that situation. We children, we use singular. So, but to elders, maka amka papai diat or maka amka papai di, give me or give us a papai. Next sentence. I want a volunteer to read for me now.
Tuka, 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 tumka.
What is this word, madam?
Tuka, tumka.
Tumka.
Narl, narl, narl dita.
Dita.
See. Father, I want to ask, I give you a coconut. Then it should, I is not coming here, no?
No, the dita. The dita. Verb, I have not come to teach you so far, correct? I have not taught you officially verbs. Dita means I give.
Okay,
it cannot
be
anybody else.
Okay.
Kokni, dita, dhauta means I run, karta, I do.
Okay.
So dita is a present simple tense which we have not learnt yet. Have I given you meaning here?
Yes. Thank you, Father.
So, if you want to be Shruti, aun tuka, tumka, naal dita, you can say. But there is no need.
Okay.
Tuka, tumka, naal dita means it is I. Now, but since now you have a doubt, I will put here aun to make explicitly, what shall I say, to become very clear.
Okay, thank you, Father.
This arm is not necessary.
Okay.
But since you have a question, I will write it. And this is the correct sentence, not wrong.
Father, you are on mute again.
Father, you're on mute.
Yeah, I told him. Come back to Zoom and unmute yourself. On the left side. Yeah.
Yeah.
Minimize it.
This is for me a mystery. Why it gets muted. And only mine. Devil is troubling me, you know. He troubles me a lot. I know that. I've seen many a times. Many a times I've seen. So I'm not at all surprised that he troubles me. He doesn't want me to teach you Konkani. Okay.
Father, what is the plural of nal?
Beg pardon?
Plural of nal, Father.
I can't hear you. Loud here. Heavy rain here.
The verb will not change with Popeye, Narl in terms of...
Madam, I can't hear you. It is heavy rain here.
We also can't hear.
Okay. You can't hear me?
We can hear you, Father. We cannot hear
Anjali.
Okay. Whoever the madam is speaking, one madam is asking me some question. I can't hear her because of her heavy shower. It's pouring.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you, madam.
Okay. The verb in dia, deet,
which one? Which sentence? Please tell me the number of which sentence you are referring to.
The first one.
Yeah, first sentence, madam. What happened?
With the object, it doesn't change with papaya or.
No, banana. You can make up. You can papaya. I said no. You can say papaya. You can put plural also. You can say maka amka papayo diat, maka amka ambe diat. You can put plural also. I said singular or plural you can put here.
Okay, so singular.
You can put masculine, plural. Feminine, neuter. No problem.
And any gender.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, see.
Father?
I will give this one. Maka, amka, ambo, dia. Very clear, no?
Oh, yes.
Maka, amka, ambe, dia. Plural, ambe. Maka, amka, papai, dia. Singular, papai. Maka, amka, papayo, dia.
Okay.
Maka, amka, pear, dia. Give me a guava. Maka, amka, peran, dia.
Okay.
Any,
thank you, Father. Thank you.
Anything you input. Yeah. See, you can construct any number of just with one sentence I given you, you can construct, I think, minimum at least 50 sentences you can create. Minimum. More. Provided you have some vocabulary, you have some nouns you know. Okay. Whatever words which have come earlier, you have in your as a soft copy, from there you see which are the nouns and you replace here.
Okay, thank you, Father.
Provided it makes sense. Any noun, see, grammatically correct sentence need not be a sensible sentence, no. Grammatically may be correct, but it makes no sense sometimes. So it should be a sensible sentence. Okay, let us go to the next one. Tuka. This is second person now. Tu become tuka. Tumka. Tumi becomes tumka. Narl dita. Aao tuka or tumka narl dita. And plural of narl is narl only. We shall learn how to make plural of all these words. But you can say now, aao tuka papayo papai dita. O papayo dita. Perdita, perandita.
Father, then it does not become, I give you coconuts.
Which one?
The second one, Father, translate.
Second one, aantuka tumka, narlidita, it could mean a coconut. It could mean coconuts also, because I told you coconut, narl is singular and plural is same.
Okay.
Same.
But in Konkani, we can specify by saying ek nal dita, no?
Then you have to say, aao ek nal dita.
Okay, specify one coconut. Okay.
You have to write this way. But, see, if you put ek, no, what is the thing? You cannot say, then coconuts, you have to remove this. You have to remove this, or you have to specify the number. Don. Aao tuka don naal dita. Aao tuka panch naal dita. That you have to do it here. This you have to remove.
Yes.
This remains then. This remains constant. This you have to remove. If you want to, you want narl only. You don't want narl. You want papai. Then narl you remove, put and papai. Now you want to put pear. Then what you have to do? You have to remove narl, you have to put pear, and you have to remove this, and you have to put ek, because it is neuter gender.
Yes, understood.
Ek pear dita. You cannot say ek pear dita. No. Ek papai dita, yes, because ek refers to masculine singular and feminine singular. Good. We shall go to third sentence. Ave, the agent or instrumental case, how becomes ave. Ami remains ami only. And tu becomes tuve. And tumi becomes tumi only. Kam kele. I. Then I should have written here we. And here I have to write one more. You. Did the work. This is the past simple tense. Ave kaam kele, ami kaam kele, tuve kaam kele, tumi kaam kele.
Father, why we can't say au?
No, you can't say, no, Kokani, they said, no, we are not speaking English. In English, I remains I. because there is no declension in English, but Konkani instrumental agent case how becomes ave.
Okay, thank you father.
If you know any European languages what I am saying, then you understand. Except I mean English, if you know Portuguese, French, Italian, Latin, Dutch, any one of those languages, then all this makes sense, because in those languages these forms are there.
Okay, thank you father.
Yeah, so you have to learn by heart these forms.
Yes,
this chart you must learn by heart.
Yes,
by heart means when the when you hear that word you must know what it means and then how to use it. Here we are, I'm helping you not only to understand but how to use also.
Yes father.
Yeah, no, it's good like that you clarify your doubts. It's good because we are here to learn, otherwise why should you come on online? You're spending so much of your time to learn. It's good. Fourth one, majer. This is the locative. Aao becomes majer, on me, amcher, on us. Tu becomes tujher, on you. Arre, this is tumcher, not ancher. Tu becomes tumcher, viswas asu. Viswas means trust. Trust be upon me or us or on you. Majer viswasasu, amcher viswasasu, tujher viswasasu, tumcher viswasasu. Okay. Fifth one, locative once again. Tumi, mager, wa amger, yeyat. You come at my or our place. Locative this is. If you have any doubt, you clear immediately. Huh? It is good. Sixth one, tuger. Once again, locative. Tumger, locative case. Bukdiyasa. You have a she goat at your place. Tuger bukdiyasa. You can, I can say, wo tumger bukdiyasa. Once again, locative. Amger. Or tumger, suneasa, dog. You don't know its gender. It could be a male dog or female dog. Then we say sune. Okay. Amger suneasa, tumger suneasa. At a or your home, a dog is there. Eighth one, mazo, amcho, tuzo, tumcho, put. My, ah, your son. You can say mazo put means my son. Amcho put means our son. Amcho, as I told you, amcho has to be said by two people. Parents only can say this, amcho put. Nobody can say amcho put. Tuzo put, your son. Tumcho put. This I can say to a single person or to the parents. Is this clear here? Difference between amcho and tumcho? Amcho put, if anybody says, it is said by parents. Both of them are there, father and mother. Together they would say amcho put. But when I say tumcho put, to whom I am saying, It could be, I'm saying to one person, either to father or mother, out of respect. Or both of them are there, and then I'm saying, oh, tum chaput Konkani shikta, I can say. Your son is studying Konkani. Ninth one, Maje, Amche, Tuje, Amche Put. Maje Put means my son. Amche Put means our son. Once again, parents are saying this, Amche Put. Nobody else can say this. Tuje Put. Somebody is telling them, telling somebody, Tuje Put. And Tumche Put. Tenth, Maji. Yes.
Father, put is for singular also and for plural also.
Yes, same.
So for sons, it's not pute or anything, it's put only.
Yeah, put only.
You.
This gender system in Konkani, you will see afterwards, is the most difficult one. The most difficult one. You have to learn by heart, memory work. Only memory work. There is nothing else. Nobody can help you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, put remains put only. Why?
But
why? We don't know.
I have a question.
Yeah. Yes, what is your question, madam?
In number 7,
yes.
How would you say at their house a dog is there?
We have not come to third person. I taught you right now only first person and second person.
Oh, okay, okay.
When third person forms come, see, you have to look at my paradigm here. See, first person and second person, correct?
Yes.
So third person I have not given you. When it comes third person, your answer, your question is automatically answered.
Okay. Thank you, Father.
Yeah. Now,
Father, in 8 and 9, mazo is when a man is speaking and
No. Mazo, you can say. Now, okay. I presume, I may be wrong, you are a married lady.
Yes, I am.
Am I right? Okay. Do you have a son, madam?
Daughter.
Let us presume you had a son, okay? Then you can say mazo put, and your life partner can also say mazo put.
And so in 9, Father, in 9 it says Maje. How is that different?
Because sons, plural, no?
Oh, okay.
Because if you have more than one son, you must say Maje Put.
Understood, Father.
Understood, no? Good.
Excuse me, Father.
Yes.
Father, sentence number 8.
Yes.
Tuzo and Tumcho. Tumcho.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. So tuzo is yours, like singular,
yes.
I think.
Yes.
And tumso can be referred for singular as well as plural, right?
Yes.
Like yes. Parents also we can tell, and as well as one parent also we can like
yes.
Indicate.
Yeah. When we say tumso, maybe one parent, but out of respect, maybe he may be your teacher.
Okay.
Or that lady who is teaching, your teacher, you cannot say tuzo put. No, you are supposed to say tumcho put. Oh, both of them are there. That lady and her life partner is there, and you are saying tumcho put baro shikta. Suppose you are a teacher and you want to tell them, then you will say tumcho put.
Okay, Father. Thank you, Father.
Be one parent you are saying, or both of them are there.
Okay. Thank you, Father.
Yeah. Good.
I had a quick question.
Yeah, which you have to say in the number.
In 8, yes. In the paradigm, it says tumcho with the circumflex over.
No. It is not circumflex. It is tumcho. There is no circumflex there. If it is circumflex, it becomes feminine form.
In the paradigm?
There is no circumflex here. It is without a circumflex. Tumcho.
Yes, there's one in the paradigm up above in the chart.
Yes. Here it is. See, here we have not learnt it.
Yeah.
It's the feminine. This is the feminine form. I will come to that. This is the feminine form. And this is the masculine form.
It's under the masculine in the chart.
In the masculine chart, you will not get a circumflex.
It's marked up on the earlier page as a circumflex.
Where here? Please show me.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Where? This is feminine form. Mojo.
In the tumcho.
Where? Tumcho is feminine form.
The tumcho, the masculine.
No, singular. This is plural. Tumcho, tumcho kite, tumcho baini. This is the followed by feminine plural.
Yes, is there supposed to be a circumflex on the first form though?
Where?
Here?
Father, she's talking about the first one. Besides tuzo, there's tumcho, right? So tumcho C has a circumflex on top.
No, it is not. It is not a circumflex. It is the. It is. So thank you, madam. Thank you. It should be tumcho. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
God bless you. Yes, it's the wrong spelling I put. It should be tumcho. Okay, but tumchi. You are right. Now we are here. The tenth one. Maji, Du, my daughter. Amchi, Du, our daughter. Tuji, Du, your daughter. Tumchi, Du, your daughter. Why it become Maji? Because Du is feminine. Therefore, it become Maji. Put is masculine. Therefore, it become Mazo. Next one. 11th one. Mojo Duo. My daughters. This is plural. Therefore, this also becomes plural. Maji becomes Mojo. Amcho Duo. Amchi becomes Amcho. Duo. Tujo Duo. Tuji Du, but Tujo Duo. Tumcho Duo, your daughters. And this is Tumchi Du. When the noun, the next noun, if it is singular, this becomes singular. If the next noun is plural, this becomes plural. Masculine, masculine. All there is an agreement. Look at here, we'll start from here. Masculine singular. Masculine singular. Masculine plural. Masculine plural. Feminine singular. Feminine singular. Feminine plural. Feminine plural. Based on this, this changes. The subject of the sentence changes. The 12th sentence. Mujhe mazar. My cat. Amche mazar. Our cat. Tujhe mazar. Your cat. Tumche mazar. Your cat. This is neutral gender. Therefore, it becomes mujhe. This is singular. Therefore, this is singular. And here, plural. Mujhe becomes Mujhi because here become Mazra. Mazar is plural is Mazra. Cats. Therefore, Amche becomes Amchi. Tujhe becomes Tujhi. Tumche becomes Tumchi. Very logical. Very logical. Once you understand, then things are that not difficult. Though it looks very fun. But it is simple. It is simple. Some practice is required. Any doubts from sentence number 1 and up to here? Some sentences you asked me and it cleared. Maybe here you might have some doubts. If you have, I will clear now. Before I proceed. no questions, I will proceed. Now that madam asked me that earlier.
Yes. The dog. Dog is Sune. Sune.
Yes. Yes.
Sune Asa. Number sentence.
Yes. Fourth, seventh one.
Thank you. Sune.
Third person. Third person, you know, we have three form. To, ti, te. And it's plural, you have learned. Te, tyo, ti. Correct? Pronoun number one, you have learned this. If you have forgotten that, then this is everything for you becomes totally new. I told you Saturday, my system is block building. Block one, block two, block three. If you know that you are block one, then block two becomes easy for you to understand. Then if you know block number one and block number two, the block number three makes sense to you. If your block one and block two are not very clear, block three becomes everything difficult. But then there is also, my system is not linear. It doesn't go like this. It is cyclic. We come back once again and we proceed. We come back once again and we proceed. So like that. Cyclic. Okay. Now, the nominative is this. This we have learned. We say to ambo, ti papai, te pair, te ambe, teo papayo, ti pera. This way we learn the plurals. Now, the accusative or dative case of to become taka, to him. And feminine ti becomes tika, neuter. Taka. So you need not worry about this column at all, because if you know masculine and feminine, whatever is masculine is applicable to the neuter gender. Let me repeat. Though here it looks such a huge thing, you need not worry at all. Look at only singular now for the time being. Don't go to this side. To, taka. Ti, tika. Te, taka. So you must say, I have to learn three forms. No, just learn these two forms. Enough. Look at here now. Agent or instrumental case. Tane, tine, tane. This and this is identical. This and this is identical. Then locative one. Tacher, ticher, tacher. Then locative two. Tager, tiger, and once again tager. This form is not usually used by Catholics, but our Hindu brethren, they use it. Tager, tiger, tager. Tager means at his place, and tiger means at her place. So you have to choose the right pronoun. These are all pronoun forms. Then, locative three, tachant, but tichant. And this one is same as masculine form, tachant. Look at the possessive one, tacho, but ticho, neuter tacho. Tachi, tichi, tachi. Tache, tiche, tache. Tache, tiche, tache. Tacho, ticho, tacho. Tachi, tichi, tachi. So this first, this column and this column is identical. So if you learn these two, that is enough. Now, this is singular. Now there is a corresponding plural. Now te. What is its accusative form? Tanka. Kyo. What is the accusative form? Tanka. And what is the accusative form of this? Tanka. So it's very simple. Here you did not learn all this. One you learn, it is applicable to feminine and neuter. That way it is simpler. But I have to give you this so that you can physically you can see they have the same forms. I could have written one statement and I could have finished off. No, for a learner, everything should be explained. Because even a, let's say, a student of 10th standard, by looking at this, they will learn on their own. Therefore, I'm giving you all the forms, but if you learn this one form here, they are repeated here. Look at, see, once again, tanka. Agent form is tani, tani, tani. Locative one, tanchir, tanchir, tanchir. Then, tangir, 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 at their place. Tanchan, 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 locative three. Possessive form, tancho, tancho, tancho. Tanchi, tanchi, tanchi. Tanche, tanche, tanche. Tanche, tanche, tanche. Tancho, tancho, tancho. Tanchi, tanchi, tanchi. There, there, there. We will learn this now in an exercise. Don't worry. It looks here very lot of, what shall I say? Words and words and words and words. You might say, what is this now? No, simpler. See.
Father.
Yes.
In this last bit that you said of tancher, is the N nasal or is it N, is it said?
Wait, this one.
In all of these, tancher, tanger, tan, like all of them, tancho.
This is nasal, nasalizing the one, no? Okay. Otherwise, it becomes okay. Tacho. See, what is the difference between this one and this one? This is tacho. This is tancho. This is ticho. This is tancho. Ta, ta. This tancho. N nasalizes this vowel. It is a, it's a nasal vowel. A-N is a nasal vowel.
Right, right. I was just confused. I thought maybe apostrophe needs to be put.
No,
like,
because we don't have a symbol in Roman script to write this vowel. So, given our alphabet, I am making use of it. As okay. I said, 26 letters we have in Roman alphabet, out of which I have used 24. Q and W I have not used. No, nobody uses those. Nobody uses. I also not used it. Okay. So this N nasalizes this. That is our rule. Consistently. In a medial position, initial position, to nasalize the vowel, use N. And at the end, you use M. See here. There are two nasal vowels here. Tan che. This is tan che, not tan chem. Not tan chem. I didn't put apostrophe here. So there are two nasal vowels here. Here there are two nasal vowels. Tan chi. Tan chi. Tan chi.
Okay.
Yeah. Is this clear? We will come, we will do the in the sentences we shall see this, but this chart will help you to understand. These are all pronoun forms we have to learn. So many pronoun forms we have in Konkani compared to English. Then there are other pronouns. We have learned this, ho, he, he, and zo, ji, je, correct? At the beginning of this class. That these also have that above chart, but I have not given everything because you understand. Haka, hane, hache, hacho, hachi, hache, and dache, so many. Hanka, hani, hanche, hancho. All these forms are there. One minute, let me check. Yes. See, all these forms are repeated here, but I have not given all. So you can just replace these words there and you get all the these forms and many other forms. So why to repeat that chart unnecessarily, which you are intelligent enough. So you understand haka, ho becomes haka, as au become maka, tu becomes tuka, ho becomes haka, all these forms. Then from this jo, you get these forms, zaka, zane, zacher, zacho, dash, dash, zachi, zache, and so on. The entire chart is applicable to this and to this. Then we have learned this pronoun kon for who means who has these forms konacho, its plural konache, if it's a feminine konachi, konacho, konache, konachi, and so many other forms. Same way kite, this we have learned this pronoun for what has these forms kitacho, what, kitache, kitachi, kitacho, kitache, kitachi, and so on. This is the new pronoun. So far, I have not introduced. First time I'm introducing apun. It is a reflexive pronoun. Oneself.
Is a reflexive. Like, yes. Mumbai Hindi. It's like pardon? Mumbai Hindi. Bombay Hindi, Mumbai Hindi, apun.
Apun. Slang, it's written apun, apun, jatai, apun, like plural.
I see. So, is a reflexive pronoun and it has this form, apnan. We will come in the sentences, you will understand all the meaning of this. But these are the forms. Apnan, apne, apnacho, apnachi, apnache. Then, they have other forms. Aplo, apli, aple, apnache, apnanger and all. So many forms are there. Okay? You don't worry. In a sentence, you will understand these forms. Let us go and do the exercise. Exercise B. Okay? I need a volunteer to read for me this sentence.
Taka, tika, taka, tanka, cake, di.
Di. See, you can say taka cake di, tika cake di, taka cake di, tanka cake di. Now this is a command. You want to give respect, then you say this way. Yeah. A person. Out of respect, you are saying diyak, and D would be a command or order. Okay. Second one. Tane, volunteer for me to read.
Tane.
1 minute. There's a mistake here. Yeah, please read.
Tane, tine, tane, tani, kam, kele.
Sorry. Kale here, why it is Kale. Tane kam kale. See, kam apostrophe is essential in our system. Otherwise, it becomes kam. Tane kam kale. Tine kam kale. Tane kam kale. Tani kam kale. This is the past simple tense. Sentence number 3. Any volunteer?
Tacher. Teacher. Tacher. Tancher. Devache.
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 Devache. Devache. Devache. Devache. Open. This is open.
Devache. Devache, Besau, Asa.
Asa. See, I will write here, then I will cancel it. See, in Konkani, we will say Dev, correct? We say Dev. This is Dev. But its other form, I change it, Deva.
Deva.
Deva, not Deva. Deva. Marathi, Marathi fellow, see in Marathi language, they have Dev and Konkani also has got Dev. But in Marathi, they will say Deva.
Deva.
Something like this. We don't have this form. We have Deva.
Deva.
Marathi doesn't have open A. This is the difference between Konkani and Marathi. Therefore, in Goa, the those who know Marathi and teach in Konkani, they make this mistake. Devache. Kida Marathi madhe devala. Pun Konkani devak. Devache. Devachi. Devan. Open. See, I have not put a circumflex here. So you have to make sound devache. Dev. Deva.
Deva.
Devache basam asa. God's asa. Blessing is upon him, her, it, them.
Dev bore kuru.
Yeah. Dev bore kuru. Because there it is close sound. But if a Hindu brethren, when they speak, amcho dev ane amche dev, because they believe in more than one God. Therefore they will say amcho dev ane amche dev. Plural. Dev plural is dev. But for Christians, dev, there is no plural. Dev only. Yeah. Fourth one. Tagir, volunteer, please, to read.
Tagir, Tigir.
One minute here. I have to. Yeah.
Tagir, Tigir, Tagir, Tangir, Ha, Veta.
Oh, Veta. Okay.
Father, I have a question.
Yes.
Okay. For Tangir, Aum, Veta, for Veta.
Little louder, please.
Instead of Veta, do you say Voita also?
That's the dialectal one.
Okay.
That's the dialectal one, Vaita. Many people say Vaita. From the very beginning, I've told you, I'll be teaching you a standard formal Konkani based on the Jesuit Franciscan's dictionaries, Sebastian Rudolph, his one, and the Konkani developed by the church, the missal, the and all. Whatever their mistakes, I don't accept. But what is correct? Based on that, and this is for information, basically the Konkani standard Konkani is of Bardeshi, that means of Goa. We have South Goa and North Goa, and in North Goa we have a taluka called Bardes. Okay, so that has become standard Konkani.
Okay.
So that becomes the base. And anything good from the Salset Konkani, I accept. Like Choi. Other day my brother said, Choi, sure, let the word come. Choi. It is not dialectal. It's another word altogether. But
okay. Veta, is Choi or Poi?
They are same it? Word.
Okay.
But there is no verb root for that then, Vaita. It is words. From that we get this Veta.
Father, excuse
me. Wrong. See, I didn't say you are wrong, mind you. I said it is a dialectal.
Father, excuse me.
Yes.
Father, in Tiswadi Taluka.
Yes.
The dialect is different. Compared to very close to Bardes, but not of Salset.
Yes.
Like Ponijakar, they speak in a different dialect.
Yes, that changes. No, this I said. No, there are so many dialects.
Okay.
There is no one dialect in Goa. You go from Pedne to Kankon. Oh, the last point is Lolie or Palole, that point.
Yeah.
They vary. Okay. Pedne, you go, they speak one way. The Pedne Catholics would speak one way, and the Kankon Catholics would speak another way. The Pedne Hindus would speak one way, and Kankon Hindus would speak way. As per their caste, they speak different ways.
Okay. Fine.
So all these changes are there. So this Konkani which I am teaching you, basically from old Konkani, I take old Konkani as a base, Monsignor Sebastian Delgado as a base, Church Konkani as a base, and from that I have built up. Whatever is correct, I have retained. Whatever there are mistakes, I have removed it. Hardly in old Konkani, there are hardly any mistakes. Hardly any. You know, it is something very admiring. That those missionaries learned the language from local people and wrote it down. They wrote it down on everything. Anyhow.
Thank you, Father.
Yeah. So, vaita, avaita is a colloquial thing. But in the standard one, avaita. Okay. Now, fifth one. Volunteer for me.
Tacho.
No, tacho. Tacho.
Tacho.
Tacho.
Tacho.
Tisho.
Tancho. Pao. Konkani Shikta.
May I know what language do you speak at home?
English.
English. So naturally in English you don't have ch sound. So it is ch sound. So it, but actually it is tacho. Tacho. Ticho. Tancho. Bao Konkani Shikta. This you have to, it takes time for you. You need a help of somebody. Okay? Shikta. His, her, their brother is learning Konkani. Why tacho? Because bao is masculine. This is singular. This is singular. Ticho is singular. This is singular. Tancho. This is singular form, tancho. Cho is singular form. Tancho ba, Konkani Shikta. Next one, volunteer.
Tache, tichi. Tiche.
Tiche.
Tanche, kam karta.
Kam karta.
Karta.
Yes. Now, tan here is kam. Tache. Means there is more than one put, therefore it's come tache. Put, plural put only. But we know this is plural, how? From this. Tache put, his sons. Or tiche put. Here it is singular, here singular, here they are plural. Tanche put kam karta. So in a sentence, you know whether the this particular word is singular or plural. Yeah. Next one.
Tachi.
No, this one.
Tachi.
Yes.
Tichi. Tanchi. Bhoin. Nasta.
Nasta. Tachi. Bhoin. This is feminine. Therefore, it is tachi. You cannot say tacho, tache now. Tachi bhain. Tichi bhain. This is a lady. I'm referring to a lady. This one. Then they become tichi bhain. Her sister. And tanchi bhain. Their sister is dancing. This is feminine. Singular, therefore this is feminine singular form. This is feminine singular form. And this is feminine singular form. Chi, chi. Eighth one. No volunteer, please. Nobody?
Tacho.
Please once again, one person only.
Go ahead, Teresa, I have said once.
Yeah.
Okay.
Say.
Tacho.
Tacho.
Tacho. Ticho. Tancho.
Tancho.
Tancho. Duvo. Randat.
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 See. Tacho. Ticho. Tancho. Duo Ranta. Your pronunciation was not exactly correct. It was, there were some mistakes. It's okay.
How do you pronounce ran? Cooking ran.
Ran. I what mistake I made here?
Ha.
1 minute.
Ranta.
Yes, Ranta.
Okay.
Ranta. Okay. Now, why it is? Tancho, because it is duo, plural. Yes. This is plural, therefore this is plural. Yes. That's all. Verb also become plural.
Yes.
Dua Ranta. If it is one daughter, it would have become Ranta.
Yes.
This is plural, therefore this is plural. This is the present simple tense.
Yes.
When we learn verb, hopefully we will learn all these things.
Yes.
Yeah. Next one.
Hacho, hicho, hicho, paro, paro, yeah. Sarta.
Yes. Let me give you the correct meaning. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Hacho. It's this person's paro, the young bull, is grazing. Hicho means lady. I'm talking about lady. Hicho paro charta. This person's young bull. Means this man's bull is grazing or this lady's bull is grazing. But I put here person because one cannot, then it refers to whether man or woman. Yeah, next one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Zaso, Jiso, Dukor, Hanga, Asa. Asa, Taka, Daundai.
Taka, Daundai. Whoever's pig is here, drive it out. Zaso, Dukor. Or Jiso, Dukor. Zaso, Dukor means this is a man and the pig belongs to this man. Jiso, Dukor means the owner is a lady. Therefore, it comes jicho. Why cho? Because dukor is masculine. Therefore, it becomes cho. Hanga asa, it's here. Taka daundai. Taka means for dukor. Taka daundai. If there was a feminine word, this would become jachi. Suppose you put guy. Then it becomes jachi, guy, hanga asa. Taka becomes tika. Down die. Am I clear? This is masculine singular, therefore this is masculine singular. This is the choice, the masculine singular form, because dukor is masculine. If guy becomes jachi, jichi, guy, anga, asa, tika down die. But if it's a cat, then what happens? Cat is neuter singular. Zache, jiche, mazar, anga, asa, taka daundai. Like this, you can generate sentences. Next one, 11th one.
Koracho, bakui, boro, na.
Once again, madam.
Konacho,
konacho,
cho.
Konacho.
Bapui baro na.
Konacho bapui baro na. Whose father is not well? Why konacho? Because bapui is masculine. Therefore, konacho bapui baro na. Okay?
Yes.
If it is a mother, then word is avoy, okay?
Achha,
then
okay.
Become konanchi avoy bari na. Baro become bari. When we come to adjectives and all, we are going to learn all these forms. But here itself I said, konancho become bapu is masculine singular. Therefore it is konancho. Next one.
Ho. Bang kityacho.
What is the material of this bench? I mean, how, out of what it is prepared? Is it wooden bench or metallic? What it is? O bang kityacho. Why kityacho? To bang. Masculine. Therefore kityacho. Why ho? Bang is masculine. Therefore ho bang kityacho. If it was a table, bang has to be replaced with the maize. And maize is a neutral gender. Then it becomes hey, maize, kityache. It becomes. Okay? Yeah. Next sentence.
So, apnang.
Word samjata. See, this is the reflexive pronoun from apun, the apnang form. To apnang word samjata. He thinks of himself as great. There is a dialectal form for this, or sazmata. This is actually samjata.
Sir, samjata and sazmata.
Both meaning is same.
But sarke utar sarke huiche.
Samjata, because in old Konkani we find samjung. Dalgat gives the word samjung. Church uses the word samjung.
So samjata is correct word, proper word.
No, no, it's not correct. What I'm say is a standard form, and sazmata is not a wrong form. No, it's a dialectal form. Confirmation.
So it is correct also?
Yes. I've been saying dialectal doesn't mean it is wrong. For instance, we say English, but in English is the language of the English people, British people in England originally. Then they went to America and became American English. That's a different story. And they went to Australia, New Zealand, Africa, and India also they came. Okay. Even in England, there are how many dialects are there? Not one dialect. Many, many dialects are there. Out of which one, the Southern London dialect became standard. That is known as Queen's English. And that the British taught us here in India. But Australian English is different. D-A-Y, we say day, they say die. The pronunciation is different.
Now, I'm saying, theatrist.
See, you must say, with all my respect to our theatrist, how did they learn Konkani? From hearing. What did they hear from their parents in their neighborhood? That they used it naturally. They didn't do a formal study of a language. See, English language we learn in school, colleges. French, there are institute to teach. German, Max Müller Bauer and all they teach. You take any language, there are formal. Portuguese you take. Here, the Institute of Kamoish, they teach. There are formal teaching is there. But when it comes to Konkani, there is no formal teaching in Roman script.
Agreed, sir.
So, therefore, it is nobody's fault. So, they continue with their dialect. And it is fair enough. No? Yeah. तो अपना वर्ड समझता तो नेक्स्ट वन अनदर पर्सन
तो अपने काम करता
करेक्ट इज द करेक्ट प्रोनाउंसिएशन डू यू नो मैडम सम कोंकणी डू यू स्पीक कोंकणी
नॉट एट ऑल
यू व्हाट लैंग्वेज डू यू स्पीक एट होम
हिंदी
हिंदी यू स्टे हियर इन गोवा
यस
सो यू हर्ड सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ कोंकणी
Yes, from the vegetable vendors.
Good. So, but at least you hear you read correctly. To apne kaam karta.
Thank you.
Good. Because you said correct this pronunciation. To. Because Hindi doesn't have O sound.
Yes.
They have O. And you said apne. Open. Open. This kaam you have. Hindi mein kaam.
You are teaching very well, Father. Thanks.
No. It's not just my teaching. It is how much you can grasp. It is your grasping power. and how much hard work you are ready to put in. It is your investment in time and energy that matters. To apne kaam karta. He is doing his own work. When you say to mujhe kaam karta, that means he is doing my work. To tujhe kaam karta means he is doing your work. But to apne kaam karta means he is doing his own work. Then we have to use these forms. Apne, apna, kano. Then next sentence.
Apne kaam, apne kharcha, kharche.
Read this word. Up to here is correct. And this one?
Karche.
Karche. Apne kaam, apne karche. One must do one's own work.
Okay.
So, in these sort of forms, we use the word, this reflexive pronoun. We use. So, we learned how many things. Let us go back. What did we learn today? This we knew. To, we knew. This one came. Ho, he, he. And jo, ji, je. These are pronouns. All third person. These are all third person pronouns. Then we went to first person. Aam, ami, maka, amka, ame, ami, majer, amcher, mager, amger, majan, amchan, majo, amcho, maji, amchi, maje, amche, maje, amche, majo, amcho, maji, amchi. This we learned, and we, in the sentences, these words are used. Not all, but most of them are used. Then second person, tu, tumi, we knew. But we learned today, tuka, tumka, tuve, tumi, tujer, tumcher, tuger, tumger, tujant, tumchant, tuzo, tumcho, tuji, tumchi, tuje, tumche, tuje, tumche, tujo, tumcho, tuji, tumchi. All these forms in examples, they have not come because you are at a very, I would say elementary stage. Now, for instance, these words have not come in the sentences for you. Nowhere, majan, amchan, tujan, tumchan, they have not come. Others, they have come somehow. Okay. Then, we did this exercise A. Based on this application we did here. All this we did. Thirteen sentences we learned, and then we went for third person. We knew this. To, ti, te, te, tio, ti, we knew. Then we got the other derived forms. Taka, tika, taka, tanka. Tane, tine, tane, tani. Tacher, ticher, tacher, tancher. Tager, tiger, tiger, tanger. Tachant, tichant, tachant, tanchant. Tacho, ticho, tacho, tancho. Tachi, tichi, tachi, tanchi. Tache, tiche, tache, tanche. Tache, tiche, tache, tanche. Tacho, ticho, tacho, tancho. Tachi, tichi, tachi, tanchi. These forms we learned. And then we did this form. We said these have the above forms, corn has got some forms. It doesn't have all the forms, some forms. Then kite has got some forms. And apud has got some forms. And then last, we did this exercise. Do you have any doubts on what we learned today? It is quite a lot, mind you. What you learned today is plenty of stuff. Needs a lot of practice. Then here I said you can remove this cake and you can put any other noun. Taka ambodiyat, you can say. Taka ambediyat, you can say. Taka papayadiyat, you can say. Taka papayodiyat. Taka kide? Alwo diyat. Alwa. Alwo. Taka dud diyat.
Biscuit.
Yes, like that you can replace. Yes, beg pardon.
Biscuit diyat.
Ah, taka biscuit diyat.
Is it biscuit or biscuit?
Biscuit.
Biscuit.
Right. So you can change, you can put. And if you like feni, taka feni diyat. Whatever. You change here. So like that you can generate your own sentences now. Removing this one word. Now cake is a feminine. Now plural is cakey. That we learn. We have today we learned only pronouns. Tomorrow we'll learn nouns. Now cake is cakey. So taka cakey diya. Like that.
Father, how would you say I want to buy 1 dozen mangoes?
Aao ek dooz. You can say that. Maka ek dooz ambezai. I want 1 dozen mangoes.
No, I want to buy.
Aao ek dooz ambe gheta. I buy.
But geta would mean take, right?
Yes.
You want to buy it from the market.
Buy, geta. Vikat geta.
Okay.
Vikat geta.
Vikat geta.
Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Yo bore koru.
Father, you cannot say gyopak.
Kide?
Gyopak. Ambe gyopak.
No. Please give me a sentence. What exactly you want to say?
Maka ek dus ambe gyopak zai.
Maka ek dus ambe gyopak zai. Yes, that gyopak has come. It actually gyopak form is not much used in standard Konkani.
Okay.
Actually, we would say gyonk zai.
Gyonk zai. Okay.
Gyonk zai. But the influence of Konkani of Devanagari script, they don't have such form. They say gyopak, everything they make pak. So that influences so much on us. Now more and more Catholics also going to use that gyopak. It is not wrong, I'm telling you. Otherwise in Bardeshi, it would be different. Maka gyongzai.
Gyongzai, correct.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
But your question is much advanced level than what I'm teaching you now here. So others may not understand all this.
Father, time up.
Yeah, but there are any questions? Because if there are any questions, I don't want to leave them unanswered.
Doctor?
Yes.
Kakud and kaklut.
Okay. Now, shall I write here? And then I delete it, okay?
Yeah.
I'll type for you, old Konkani. This is the old Konkani word which you find in this dictionary. This dictionary. Kakulti. Why? Because in old Konkani, everything ends with vowel. All the words ending in vowel. No words ending in a consonant.
Okay.
Everything. We say now disu, no? Correct? For day? Old Konkani is disu. Disu. Anyhow, kakulti. This kakulti became in the then it became kakult. Then it became kakult. Okay? In modern Konkani. Then are these people cannot pronounce this double la. They cannot pronounce this double la. You must remember this. So they made kakut. Kakulti, kakult, kakut.
What is kakut meaning?
Mercy.
Mercy.
Father,
yes?
There is something like kaklut. Kaklutdi, kaklut.
Ah, okay. That is in linguistic is called apology. So I will put here.
Okay. Kaklut. That's different.
Became this is the correct form. Only vowel was dropped. Only if the vowel was dropped, it became kakult. This is known as haplology. That means change of this thing. Like in English, let me write here. This is the word in English, correct? A-S-K, correct? But yes. In Goa, English teachers, forget about other teachers, they pronounce like this. Instead of saying ask, they say ax. I have no much contact in Salset people, but Salset teachers I've been teaching, Bardesh teachers, all most of them will say ax. It's ask. This is known as haplology. Interchange of the consonants over. So this kakulut, kakulut is the haplology. And from the and further from this become kakut.
But doctor, Gayana Jalache kaklut munaha kaklut.
Yeah, actually that's as I said, no?
Yeah, kaklut.
This one.
Yeah, during mass and all, I think they use.
No, kaklut. No, no, mass. This is.
No, no, okay. But only one L, father. Kaklut.
No, this is what I say. They cannot pronounce the double L. No.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
They cannot say kaulo, they say kavo in Bardeshi Konkani. Kavo, K-A-V-O.
Oh, and even for Dodo, they say Dovo.
Dovo, D-O-V-O, Bardeshi. Yeah. This is basically because our Catholics in Goa do not know one Indian language. One Indian language they didn't learn. If they had learned one language, any language, you see Marathi, if they had learned Marathi, Marathi was here much before Portuguese came. Much before Portuguese came, Marathi was here. The Hindu religious literature in Goa was written in Marathi before Portuguese came. So if our Catholics had learned Marathi at least, then our Konkani would have been better. So now we have to relearn many things. It is not impossible. Double dolo to say dolo is not impossible.
Father, what about our history of Konkani? You are saying what Marathi was much before.
So yes.
What about our Konkani?
Konkani remained as a spoken language.
Okay.
Till the missionaries came, Konkani was a spoken language. Therefore, Father Thomas Stevens, who wrote the Konkani grammar? Where I kept his grammar now? Somewhere it is here. Anyhow, who wrote the Konkani grammar he wrote the Krista Puran in Marathi, in Goa, for the new Christians. Right. For the new Christians, he wrote Krista Puran in Marathi.
Okay.
Same way, missionaries wrote prose in Konkani and poetry in Marathi, all the missionaries.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
Because that was the language of literature when the missionaries were here. So Marathi is not new to Goa. This we must admit, this historical fact, we must admit.
Okay, Father. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, Father, but some Goan Catholics, when I speak to them, then they say that this is Marathi Konkani. This is not Catholic Konkani.
See, there is no Marathi Konkani and this thing because they don't know what is Konkani, first of all. That's what I say. If they had learnt one language, any one language, they would have made distinction between what is Konkani and what is Marathi. Konkani Ambo, Marathi Amba. Marathi ghoda, Konkani ghodo. There is a difference. Grammar, there is a difference. Konkani, there is o. Marathi, there is no o. Konkani, there is a. Marathi, there is no a. Konkani, there is fa, fool. Marathi, they say pool, ph, phul for them. We don't have ph sound in Konkani. We have fa from Persian. And Portuguese, mainly from Persian one, and Portuguese sound also it came. So we have F, fool. So like that. If you know a language thoroughly and if you do study, then you know what is Konkani and what is Marathi. Portuguese and Spanish, are they one and the same languages? No, they are two different languages, though they have similarities. Dutch and German, same. They are similar, but not identical. So you cannot say Dutch is German and German is Dutch. No. Same way, Konkani is Konkani, Marathi is Marathi. There is no Marathi Konkani.
Yes, Father.
Yeah.
Father, yes. How will you say I love you in Konkani?
Oh, my goodness. Whom you want to say this now? Aao tujo mok karta.
Karta, okay.
Karta.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Aao tujo mok karta. But be careful to whom you say this, huh?
Okay.
Yes, you can say to your lover and to your life partner.
Okay.
Or your children.
But
you say your neighbor, my goodness, you will trouble
no, no. Again. No.
That's okay. Okay. So, Deo Barankaru. And this file I'll be sending today itself to Savio, so you will get it, so that tomorrow before class you can go through once again the entire this matter, and my any typing mistake if are there, you please bring to my notice, because I've got so many systems in my head, Roman script traditional. Then I revived it. Then I made this perfect system. So I have three systems of Roman script. I have Devanagari way of writing in my head. I have the Kannada script of writing in my head. So I have different systems. So when I write, I do make mistake. Then I realize, yes, no, this is the mistake. So please point out if there are any mistakes and mainly bring your questions and doubts. Because based on this, tomorrow we will study nouns, which is a much more difficult topic. Yeah. Pare, Mogaso.
Mogaso.
Tumkai.
Tumkai Diu.
Tumkai Diu.
Tumkai Diu.
Yes.
Tumkai Diu.